hardware that is available on our computer, like computer screen, maybe a mouse and keyboard. There are many things here which are the computer operating system. So since the computer only understands binary language, so we cannot tell a computer directly what to do, right? So what we can do, we can tell the operating system what to do. We can tell the operating system what to do, and then the operating our hardware what to do, and this way our operating system can interact with the hardware. Turn off your microphone, everyone. Yes, thank you. Okay, so here you can see a diagram. Can you see the diagram? Reply in chat. If you can see this diagram, reply in chat. Why? Yes. Okay. So the software is communicating with the operating system. The software is not actually directly communicating with the hardware. It is only communicating with the operating system, and then in turn is communicating with the hardware. So for example, let's say this Google using in our phone. We are using this software, right? And we are using this software to communicate among ourselves. But this software is not directly using your camera. Because the hardware does. What it does, this software, that is Google Meet, is telling the operating system. That is, in our case, this is Android. It is telling the operating system Android that what to do. And that is Android in turn uses your microphone and camera to communicate between these softwares. So the class that we are doing, it is, and that is Android. Okay, so operating system is a bridge hardware. And the user, so for a user, he, she needs an application software. Application software allows user to send work the computer. So the operating system supervises all the tasks to be the instructions to the hardware. Next topic that we have are functions of operating system. So what are the different functions our operating system performs? So what are the different functions that the operating system is doing? The first one is starting the computer. So if when you start the computer, that is when you click on that power button, the starting of the computer, this process is also controlled by operating system. Then from the various that we are doing together, for example, we might have more than one app running at the same time, or in computer we might be doing some other work also. So there are more than one processes usually running on a computer. So since we have only one processor, each processor needs to control all the tasks. The whatever you are doing, all the tasks needs to by the operating system for the processors to do. Number three, hardware resource management.
Sir, your voice is not coming clear.
My voice is not clear.
No, sir.
Should I go a bit slower?
Yes. Sir, my mobile volume is too.
You can use your headphone. Are you using headphone?
No, sir. My mobile headphone jack are not.
Oh, okay. We have to try, right?
Sir, please talk loudly.
I should talk loudly.
Sir, please speak up pitch louder.
You tell me.
Sir, please talk loudly.
Okay. So the third point was hardware resource management. So can one of you tell me what is a resource? Resource, can anyone tell me? You can tell me in chat also. What is a resource? Yes, anyone? Resource? No. Okay, basically, resource is something that we can utilize to do certain kind of tasks. Okay. So resources are basically something which we can utilize to do certain kinds of tasks. So here we are talking about hardware resources. So what are hardware resources? You have heard about RAM, our hard drives. You have heard about, what else you have heard about? Can you tell me? Yes, resources. These are some of our resources which we can utilize. But what if a single task is taking up all of your resources, means all of your RAM is being used up and all of your being used up by a single process? In that case, any other any other process that you might have, that process will not have any RAM, any hard drive or any processor to use, right? So system, what it does, it controls how much resource to be allocated to which process. A process only gets that much resource that it needs, not more than that. Then we can, that operating system controls the software resource management. So how it controls the software resources? It controls which software is running when and when that software needs to be closed. Sometimes you might see that if a software is not doing, means responding properly, the operating system shuts it down automatically. It says that your software has crashed, right? So this thing is also done by our operating system. So if a software is not working properly, that our hard drive, our operating system shuts it down automatically. If this much is clear, you can type Y in chat. Software resource management and hardware resource management. If it is clear, you can type Y. Okay, so next one is managing files and folders. So how can we manage files and folders? We know that in Windows, we save all our files and folders in Windows file directories like this. Here we can have many different files. We can create folders also, and we can arrange them in this way.
Sir?
Yes?
I did not understand the software. Sir, I did not understand the software resource management.
Okay, software resource management. Basically, when you are running some kind of software, it might happen that software is not working properly. And whenever you try to do something, it is not doing. In that case, what happens, a little bit later, your operating system automatically shuts it down and gives you a message that your program has crashed or your software has crashed like this, right? That thing is performed by the operating system. And operating system is managing your software, how it should work and how it should respond. If it is not responding well, then it is closed automatically. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Number six, memory management. Clear, RAM management. You know what is primary memory of our computer? It is the RAM, RAM access memory. So we know that RAM is very much computer to work properly. If there is not enough memory in a computer, that computer cannot perform multiple tasks together. So basically, we're storing temporary data. For example, while it is performing some kind of operation, whatever data it is generating, it stores not in the hard drive, but in the memory or the RAM. So how much RAM should be allocated to which process, it is also controlled by our operating system. If a single process takes all the memory available, then other processes cannot run at all. The next topic we have is starting a computer. So can you see this diagram here? Type Y. If you can see this diagram, Y. Okay. So what is the first one here? Post. The full form is power on self test. The full form is when you turn on your computer, your operating system is loading instantaneously. First thing it does, when you turn on your computer, it checks whether the basic input of computer, what is the basic input output system? The short form is iOS. So whether it's in your computer's RAM or not. So here some points are important. BIOS, then ROM. So your BIOS, your BIOS resides in your ROM, in your computer. So when you start your computer, first thing is checked whether this BIOS is inside the ROM. Then what is checked? It BIOS has the required instructions. So when your computer is started, your BIOS takes control first of all. So BIOS checks whether all the input output devices are connected or not. It will check connected. It will check whether your display is connected, your RAM, your keyboard is connected. If these are not connected, then your computer cannot be started. Okay. The next thing it does, number two, BIOS first does a power on self test, that is POST, to make sure that all the components of the computer are operational and ensure that the user can begin working on the computer. For example, if your RAM is not connected to your computer, or maybe the RAM is not working at all, okay, what happens? If this happens, then your computer will not start and you will get a message in your screen that it does not have any memory, so it will not start. So the POST, that is the power on self test, checks whether all the components that is required for your computer are connected or not. It checks operating system is loaded RAM from the hard disk. So our operating system is actually stored in our internal hard drive or secondary memory. So the BIOS, after checking the POST check, it copies all the files of the operating system into our RAM. So let me write it also. With all the files of operating system in our memory, that is, then what it does, after the operating system is loaded, it takes over the control of the computer. So after the operating system is loaded, then BIOS is no longer required, and then OS takes over. Entire process of loading operating system into RAM is referred to as booting. This is a very important word. So this is a very important word. It might come as a definition. Okay. So what is booting? You have to. If someone is coming, then someone else might be turning on their microphone. Okay. So tell them to turn it off. Okay. The next thing is process management. So process is a program in execution. After the entire control is over by the operating system, it assigns the task given by the user to the processor. So whatever task is performed by the processor execution. So to decide the process execution or process to be executed first and which process to be executed later, there are some following points follow. Number one, choosing the right process in a multi-programmed system. So what can it simply means that this kind of computer is then one program or more than one process at a single time. So if you are in a multi-programmed system, then your operating system has to choose the right process first. Number seven, deletion of the process. So how, when to delete a process after it is over. So these are also controlled by the operating system. These are all part of the process management. So when CPU is getting which process to execute, it is also controlled by the process management and in turn by the operating system. Number four, temporarily inactive. For example, RAM is waiting for from you. So in that case, this program is inactive at certain time, and for that case it is not in our processor, it is removed from our processor because it is now inactive, and it becomes active again later on for process executed. Number 5, process synchronization and communication. In case two processes are communicating to each other, it might happen that more than one process are trying to communicate with each other, also being controlled by the operating system. Number 6, deadlock. So this one, you can see the definition of deadlock in word where see definition, you type Y. Anyone, if you can see this definition here, you can type Y. This is an important definition. You have, so what is deadlock? Is a situation when two programs try to access the same resource at the same time and effectively each other. Let's say you are in a class, okay, and they're available to take that particular seat, and you guys are fighting among each other to take the seat. So what happens? Nobody's seat is empty. Neither of you are able to sit there, and you are only fighting. So this kind of deadlock. Two or more processes resources at time for successful execution. So these kind of deadlocks are also maintained by our operating system. If this kind of two different processes are fighting for a single resource, then our operating system will decide which resource and which process is not getting the resource. Okay, next topic is hardware resource management. So last topic was process management. This one is resource management. Storage by computer. These are referred to as hardware resource. So when you are operating at which an input or device has to respond. For example, let's say you are typing something. So obviously, the keyboard is doing some, and your operating system has identified that yes, hardware resource is doing work, and I have to respond to that. The operating system from basic task. Yes. Tell me what happened.
Tell your voice.
Sorry, your voice is not clear.
No.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Again, this
particular. Some extra sounds are also coming.
Other sounds are coming.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If it is better, run now. Write me. Right now, tell me. Okay, I'll be explaining this topic again. Hardware resource management. Basically, what happens when you connect different input devices to our computer? So these are all hardware resources. For example, if you connect your mouse, it is a hardware resource. If you connect your keyboard, it is also a hardware resource. So if you connect all these hardware resources, then what happens? Your operating system has to be responsive to them. If you are typing something, operating system has to know that yes, you are typing something. It should be taken as an input. If you are moving your mouse, that is also you are giving some kinds of input, and your operating system needs to be aware of that. The operating system performs basic tasks such as recognizing input from the keyboard. So it recognizes your input out input to the display. It sends those whatever you have inputted into your display also. Directories. It also controls peripheral devices such as disk drives and printers. So hardware manages devices like disk drives and printers. Connecting your disk drives or printers or maybe scanners to your computer. Those are also maintained by the. So Right. Okay. You can see this diagram here. Operating system is controlling all the input devices and output devices. Though these are together called as a peripheral devices. Mouse, speaker, monitor, these are all peripheral devices. Operating system controls the loading as well as the execution of any software used by the user. So the communication between the software and the hardware, application communicate with the devices through the operating system, and the operating system manages devices through device drivers. So if that multiple users are using the same software, then the operating system allots time slots. What is happening here? Let's say, for example, we are using this Google, right? So when my audio is being recorded by the software, that is Google Meet, that audio is then transferred to the operating system, and then operating system uses our hardware in my phone to send this audio over to the internet, and then in your computer, your hardware, that is your phone, is receiving that audio. And then that audio is being taken by the operating system, and then the operating system gives that audio to your Google Meet, and then you are able to hear my audio. This much is clear? How it is being sent? Okay. So here there is one more term mentioned here, that is called device drivers. One more thing is mentioned here, that is device drivers. Now, what are drivers? The drivers are not those drivers of your cars. Okay, so device tells the operating system how to control a certain device. For example, you might be having a computer, okay, and you have bought a new keyboard. The computer doesn't know how this keyboard is managed. Okay, so what is happening? Along with your keyboard, we'll be getting a device driver for that keyboard, and that installed in your computer. So your computer knows from that device driver how to control that keyboard. You might be noticing that when you insert a new pen drive in your computer, does not first thing it does, it installs some things, right? Have you seen this? If yes, then type Y. Is the device driver for your pen drive. Okay. The next topic is managing files and folders. Operating system folders and directories created on a hard disk or any other secondary storage. So it also controls the manipulation and deletion of files and folders. In this file directory, you understand directory? Directory is a tree-like structure where there is a parent and there is a child. Folders. When you go inside that folder, there are some more folders or there may be some more files. So it also manipulation and delete. We can move the files from one location to another, or we may also delete them. The operating system manages storage. One of the modules, that is file manager. The file manager is this one. In for Windows, is this one, file manager. For Android operating system, the file manager could be something different. It will be called file manager. The file manager maintains an index of the file names and their location on the disk. Okay, so a hard disk in computer is referred to as C drive. So this is very common in your computer, in your laptop. You will see that you might be having different drives called C drive, B drive, F drives, like this. So when you store operating system, it is usually stored in your C drive by default. Or divided into more logical drives, then they are called DE in sequence. So usually our hard drives are partitioned And that's why our operating system resides in C drive, and the other drives are called D, E, F, and so on. Depending upon the requirement of the users, folders and folders inside folders can be created in each logical drive. So this we already know, we can create a folder inside another folder, and inside that folder also we can use more than one folders. And files also we can store. So here in this diagram, it's an example given how this folder structure is working. So it is a tree-like structure, if you can see. This hard disk C drive is having five different folders, folder 1, folder 2, folder 3, folder 4, and file 1. So four folders and one file. You have to see that this file is not having any more folders or files inside it, because files cannot contain anything else. But folders can contain more folders or files. So folder 1 is containing folder 11 and file 2. And then folder 11 is containing file 5. Like this for other folders also. Okay, next topic is memory management. The operating system also manages the allocation of the memory of the computer system. It allocates the memory to a process, and it also defines that if a process gets completed, then the memory allocated for the process will be released. What is happening here? Let's say a single process is running here in your computer, and it is taking up 500 MB of your memory or RAM. Okay. After the process gets completed, what the job of operating system is that it will free your RAM from this process. Since your process is over, this process does not need that RAM anymore. So it will be cleared off. If it is clear, you can type Y. If this much is clear, you can type Y. Okay. Okay. Next is an operating system therefore does the following. It allocates or dedicates memory space as requested or required by a program. When a program requires some memory, our operating system gives it that particular amount of memory, and when that program is done executing, that memory again gets deallocated. That is, this maps of processes and the memory locations allocated to it. So whatever memory locations are given, it keeps track. That operating system knows which process is running on which memory location. Okay, so that it can access easily. They control the program for allocating memory. So which program is executing when, it keeps track. The memory management, it keeps track of all the memory, and which program sequence is using which memory, it can keep track. Yes, someone is typing N. You did not understand it? Which topic you did not understand? If you did not understand, you can type N. Kamalaksh, you did not understand something?
Yes, sir.
Sayan, who is typing N then? If it is not clear, then you can type N. If it is clear, then you type Y.
Sir.
Okay. Components of operating system.
Sir, that one memory management, I did not understand.
Yes, memory. What is happening in memory management? So let's say you have a task, okay, or you are running some software, and that software is taking up 500 MB of your memory. You have, let's assume, and that particular software is taking up 500 MB of your memory. So obviously, when you execute this software, your operating system will give 500 to this particular process or this particular software. And while it's running, that software will have that MB of memory. But when that software is done running, that is, you have closed it already. So should that amount be still be occupied that software? No. Operating system checks whether that software not, and when that software is not running anymore, that memory gets freed again. It was given to this software, but now it is taken back again because that software is not using that memory anymore. And like this, your operating system keeps track of which MTB being used and which memory is not being used anymore, so that it can be freed up to be used by some other program or some other software. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what else memory management does? It maps or keeps track of the process and the memory locations allocated to it. Memory management, that is the operating system, is giving some memories to some different softwares or some different processes, right? So the operating system or the memory management keeps track of which location of memory it has given to which process. For example, whatever memory you have in your RAM, all of them have different addresses or locations. Okay, so which memory is given to which process, it is being kept track of by the operating system. That is, operating system knows that yes, this particular software is running on this particular memory location and that software is running on some other memory location. So it can keep track of all these memory locations. Lastly, it controls the program sequence for allocating memory. So which program should get which memory and which program has taken which memory, it is also being kept track of by the memory management. Okay, so for today I am keeping only up to this much. From the next topic I'll be discussing on the next class. If you have any doubt up to this, you can ask me now. You can turn on your microphone and you can ask me. Anyone? Okay. Okay, so what is your next class? English, which it will take?
Come in.
So you wait for them and I'll be accepting her, then I'll leave.